गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः. We were at the question, if this teaching is accepted, that is, that happiness is the nature of the self and everything we interact in life, attributing happiness to that object or that thing, whereas actually the happiness is your nature. So happiness is not in the object with which you are interacting. If that is accepted, then what is the use of inquiry? What is the use of the inquiry about the reality or unreality of the self? Because you are that. Sab kuch starts from you only. So towards that, turyam padam nitya sukhasya dhameti. Meti evam prabuddha dvidite tha sadho. Ito viraktasya turiya liptasoho. Viraktasya turiya liptoso. Liptasoho. Jagad vicharana phalam kimasti.
Jagad vicharana phalam kimasti.
Kimasti? What is the reason? For what? For the aspirant who has thus learned from the sage guru that the supreme state is the home of eternal happiness, and who is therefore indifferent to this world and intent on winning that state, what is the use of an inquiry concerning the world? Why should you inquire into the world? Then you should think only about the self, isn't it? But every scripture tells you to inquire into the ephemeral nature of the world. Why? It is told, the Ramana Maharshi says, Sanvanyathava bhavatu prapancho.
Sanvanyathava bhavatu prapancho.
Labdhavyamatrasti kimasya sadho.
Labdhavyamatrasti kimasya sadho.
Satturyam advaita mutanyathava.
Satturyam advaita mutanyathava.
Apyastam tadevepsi tamasya nanyata.
Apyastam tadevepsi tamasya
nanyata. Tongue twisters. Let the world be real or otherwise. What is there in it for the aspirant to strive for? And let the reality in the supreme state be non-dual or otherwise. It is that alone that he wants to win, nothing else. The two questions are concerning the reality of the world and the other concerning the reality, the non-duality of the real self, which are really one. Both questions become superfluous for one that has resolved to strive for that state. There is also another reason for this. The one who is striving to be the self, to recognize that he is the self, is using different ways, means, logic, etc., etc. Here, his own experience was being given that all happiness is coming from him only, it is not from something or someone. So, is there any, if that is the case, then do I need to inquire into the unreality of the world? And do I need to inquire into the reality of the truth? It's inquiry only, no? What we are doing is inquiry only. Is there required? So, yes, answer is that simple, what you are saying. But the mind doesn't allow it, no? Mind doesn't allow it. Kimadvayam sat kimuneti bodhum.
Kimadvayam sat kimuneti bodhum.
शक्ये हि तुर्ये स्थितिमेत्य सत्ये शक्नोति कस्तत्त्वमदो निबोधुम् ब्राह्म्यन्नवस्थात्रितये विमुग्धः only by becoming firmly established in the real self of that supreme state can one know definitely whether that reality is non-dual or not. How can anyone become aware of that truth while wandering confusedly in the three states? And that is why inquiry is required. And what is the inquiry about? Inquiry is about how everything that is other than the self is changing, so not worth pursuing. And the substratum of all that change is the unchanging principle, and that I am. And your attention has to go towards that and accept it and get established. Only after establishment will we come to know that the inquiry was not required. But while you are caught up in the illusion, you need inquiry to shoot out of the illusion. As long as you are caught up in the gravity of the earth, you will go through day and night and day and night. And sit in a rocket which has the capacity to shoot you out of the earth's gravity, then there is no day and night. There is no day and night outside in the orbit. So same here, all duality ends. But you have to break through the gravity. The gravity is of the mind. And what is the gravity in the mind? Identification.
So you have to go outside to come inside. Not necessarily.
Wrong.
Because
wrong conclusion. I did not say that. I did not say that. Where did I say you have to go outside to come inside?
Because of the way our mind and system mechanism works, and we get so much dragged and pulled in the outside, the mind, you can't straight away calm the mind, so let the mind, you observe the mind and pull it back to the inside, towards yourself.
You don't observe the world. You bring your attention. You cannot stop the mind from thinking. You bring your attention to the self. And then you inquire, what is this self? You reassess your experiences. That is what inquiry is all about. On one hand, dukkha nivritti, and the other side, sukha prapti. On one hand, how apara is ephemeral and how para is permanent. This is, inquiry is not between waking and dream. Inquiry is between what is real and what is unreal. And what is the difference between the two? Real is permanent, real is unchanging, real is complete. Real is all that there is. And in reality, there is no scope of changing ever possible. No scope. And what is changing? Which cannot exist without the real, but it cannot come to know the real. And we are running after only unreal. So how will we get to be established? Let the world be real or otherwise, what is there in it for the aspirant to strive for, and let the reality which one we were on, 71 or 72? And let the reality in the supreme state be non-dual or otherwise, it is that alone that he wants to win and nothing else. When this type of urge comes inside, that I don't want to caught up, whole idea is I don't want to get caught up in dogmas, I don't want to get caught up in doctrines, I don't want to get caught up in philosophies, because all these things are at the mind level. I want to be me. I want to be me. And in me, the pristine me, the spirit, it supports all, everything. So I don't want to get caught up in any argument or discussion about which path or which religion. No. I want to come to this unattached, unsullied, pure consciousness, which is ever complete. It's full. The two questions, one concerning the reality of the world and the other concerning the non-duality of the real self, are really one. Both questions become superfluous for one who has resolved to strive for that state. So one who is searching for that infinite pure consciousness, that is essential nature, is subjectively, for him, no amount, nothing is his focus. His focus is not at all outside. Dattatreya Maharaj, he was so at one with it that whatever his eyes are seeing, ears are hearing, whatever his experience was, it was all becoming an impetus to for his mind to fall back into the self. Is that happening to us? Yes, maybe, because we are going to satsangs. We are taking satsangs. Why? We want to expose our mind again and again to that. So something is driving that. But not enough that abhi ho gaya. Let the explosion hasn't happened yet. It doesn't need to happen also. It can be a smooth glide. There is another reason for this. Kimadvayam sat kimuneti bodham bodhum. Sat kimuneti bodhum. Shakye hi turye sthitat sthiti metya satye. Sthiti metya satye. Shaknoti kastatva madoni bodhum. Kastatva madoni bodhum. Brahmyannavasthatritaye vimugdah. Nobody, no problem. Don't get worked up. It's okay. We can do it again. Only by becoming firmly established in the real self of that supreme state can one know definitely whether that reality is non-dual or dual. No amount of hair splitting in your mind is ever going to make you come to know. Because where you are trying to work out is the not self. And self is beyond not self. Not self is the phenomena. Self is the noumena or the reality. So if the effect can never come to know the cause, we are not talking here about cause effect, but that which is existing in its own absence. Phenomena is mithya, no? Illusion is what? That which is existing in its own absence. For example, rainbow. For example, mirage. How can it, similarly, this whole world, our mind also, how will it come to know that which is its substratum?
Unless it dissolves.
So here, how can anyone become aware of that truth while still wandering, confusing, in a confused state in this world? It is not. And here, what is our world? The three states. Never take only the waking state. We are given overdue importance to waking. Our whole day experience is waking, dream and deep sleep. And they are unreal. Why? Changing, coming and going. Self doesn't come and go. We are so focused on coming and going of the waking, little bit of delay from some party or some place, or from satsang. Swamiji, time ho gaya, lunch time. Swamiji, time ho gaya, it's time to sleep. We have got work tomorrow morning. Why? Attention is not on the divine. Attention is on the sleep state. Attention is on what has to be done tomorrow. Bhagwan Sri Ramana gives the following analogy to impress this fact. Kshepohi lomnam nikarasya yuktah. Kshepohi lomnam karasya yuktah. क्षुरापनीतस्य विना परीक्षाम् परीक्षाम् तुच्छस्य तद्वज्जगतोस्य दानम् तुच्छस्य तद्वज्जगतोस्य दानम् चर्चा विना युज्यत एव साधोः जस्ट एज इट इज प्रॉपर टू थ्रो अवे द हीप ऑफ थॉर्न शॉर्न हेयर विदाउट स्क्रूटिनी सो इट इज राइट फॉर द एस्पिरेंट टू टर्न अवे फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड विच फॉर हिम इज ऑफ नो वैल्यू विदाउट इंक्वायरी कंसर्निंग इट सो अनदर एग्जाम्पल दैट कम्स इन द उपनिषद इज द वॉमिट that once things are we eat and when you vomit do you say oh that was such a nice thing that I ate okay let me eat the vomit again but I don't want to waste it you know exactly the same way once the hair is cut you don't there are people nowadays it's become a business they sell hair cut hair for the dolls and this and that but do you care what he does with that hair No. You got zero value for it. Just like that, for the dream also there is zero value. And this is a waking dream. Zero value for it. So if it is zero value, if you do not inquire into the dream that you had last night, why you don't inquire? Because you can't even remember it. What was the dream? So same way when we wake up to our own essential nature, means we come to establish in it, the waking plane will not be available for us.
The demarcations
just like the dream state is not available when you wake up in the morning, when you wake up from this waking dream into your natural state, to the self that you essentially are, then this waking will not be available to you. Then what inquiry will you do? What inquiry will you do? Is it required?
No.
It's not required. Think. But our problem is, oh, if I realize, then if I forget to pay my car loan, if I pay, unwanted thinking, how not to realize? Why? The obsession with the waking world. You don't have the same obsession about the dream. There also you took lot of loan and you bank went and and left it for someone to pay. They're still paying. Heyam prapancham sa vihaya turnam.
Heyam prapancham sa vihaya turnam.
Antar mukhatvena yateta siddhyai. Antar mukhatvena अन्तर्मुखत्वेन यतेत सिद्ध्यै अन्तर्मुखत्वेन हि साधनं स्यात् विश्वं तदर्थं ननु हेयमेव द एस्पिरेंट विल नेचुरली टर्न अवे फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड एट वंस एंड विद हिज माइंड टर्न्ड इनवर्ड्स विल स्ट्राइव फॉर द गोल इट इज बाय टर्निंग द माइंड अवे फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड दैट द क्वेस्ट इज मेड एंड फॉर दैट रीजन द वर्ल्ड इज सर्टेनली टू बी रेनाउंस्ड सो हाउ डज द स्पिरिचुअल जर्नी बिगिन Only when you become introvert, namaste. Only when you become introvert. Those who say that we want to be have one foot in the world and one foot in the spirituality, nothing will work. Only frustration. Only confusion. When we go to the temple, what do you do? When you prostrate in front of the God, what do you do? You bow down, you close your eyes, you become introvert. But that beautiful statue is out there. Why don't you look at it? Huh? Then come up. No, but you are lying in front of the Lord, Because everyone knowingly or unknowingly knows that the divinity is within, the peace is within, the tranquility is within. See? It's a natural. So here he says that that only by turning the mind away from the world, so consciously ever be aware. We are not saying run away from the world, we are not saying escape from the world. This satsang is going on in the world only, but where is our attention? On the, every verse is bringing it back to the self, isn't it? So this practice that is happening in this environment, can we extend this throughout our day when we are not in the satsang also? Here there is a support of a teacher, there is a commitment of the text continuously going on. When you are away out of this satsang, then there is no text, then what can you do? Then you take the name of the Lord, then you keep repeating, self is inside and outside, self is smaller than the smallest and larger than the largest, self is, I am that self which is all that there is, it is supporting the waking dream and deep sleep without, and even though it is supporting, it has never got corrupted. Then why am I feeling that way, that I am corrupted? Why do I feel that I am being hijacked by the waking dream and deep sleep? Why do I feel that I am a waker, dreamer, sleeper? Oh, I am going wrong somewhere. Come back. For the few moments of silence, you are with yourself. Again you find that mind somewhere. Let it go. Our attention, even right now, again I am saying, our attention must be on that principle because of which experiences are happening in the mind. Thought, and what are experiences? Nothing but thoughts. Your attention should be, for whom are these experiences? Our common man's attention is on the experiences. Our attention should be, for whom is the experience? It's for me. Be that. Let the experience senses come and go. This foolish notion that I am creating my own experiences, that's also throw it out of the window. This wrong belief that I am creating my reality. Nobody can create your reality. It's happening. Unnecessarily, you, by saying I am going to create my reality, again you have got identified. Again you have got identified, because only that is going to happen which is ordained. So is it a pessimistic view of life? Is it a defeatist view of life? I can't do anything. Yes, and one person may go into depression. But here our goal is pure consciousness that I am, which is full, which is happiness, which is bliss, which is all-knowing. So without your focus on this permanent principle, if you reject the world, you will go into depression.
Yes.
So
if you,
why people say, what did you experience from it?
Don't. You say, next life I'll
because
tell you.
Everywhere you go, any talk or anything, what did you experience from it?
Hmm.
So you have to tell in words.
No, you don't have to tell. They are taking the Mickey out of you.
What?
Mickey. वो आपको चिढ़ा रहे हैं.
अच्छा.
क्यों चिढ़ा रहे हैं? क्योंकि उनको पता है कि आप explain नहीं कर पाओगे. और अगर आप explain करते हो, उनके सर के ऊपर से निकल जाता है. तो वो उनका conclusion ये आ जाता है कि हम इनसे ज़्यादा smart हैं, ये तो अपना time waste कर रहे हैं. हाँ, ये दुनिया ऐसी है, दुनिया ऐसी है. इसलिए जब कोई प्रश्न पूछता है, ज्यादा सीरियसली मत लो, वो टाल दो जब तक कि वो प्रश्न सिंसियरली ना पूछा जाए.
नहीं, कोई फंक्शन अटेंड करो, कोई लेक्चर सुनो, उसके बाद पूछते हैं व्हाट वाज योर एक्सपीरियंस.
नहीं, सिर्फ बोल दो टाइम पास के लिए गए थे.
सोने आए थे?
नहीं नहीं, टाइम पास के लिए गए थे. टाइम पास हो गया बस. नहीं, ऐसे थोड़ी ना होता है टाइम पास होता है. यू टेल मी व्हाई आई वेंट देन.
फिर तो वो हमें डल मानते हैं. यू वर डल.
हाँ, आई एम डल. आई एम डल, आर्ग्यू नहीं करना है. कहाँ जहाँ पोजिशन ले लिया कि मैं डल नहीं हूँ, क्योंकि देन यू थिंक दैट यू आर इंटेलिजेंट, देन दे विल ट्रबल यू मोर. यू से या आई एम बुद्धू, आई एम डल, आई एम स्टूपिड, एंड यू विल हैव द लास्ट लाफ. ज़्यादा अपनी तीस मार खा के उसके सामने मत दिखाओ जो पूछते हैं कि क्या मिला वहाँ पे जाके, क्योंकि उनको उसमें बिलीफ नहीं है, इसलिए वो आपकी बिलीफ तोड़ना चाहते हैं, आपका फेथ तोड़ना चाहते हैं. या आप, या कई बार ऐसे भी होता है कि उनको पता, उनको लगता है कि इतने सारे आते हैं चले जाते हैं बेवकूफ़ बना के, हाँ तो हमारी मम्मी तो कहीं फंस नहीं रही है, या हमारे फ्रेंड कहीं फंस तो नहीं रही है, देयरफॉर दे आस्क यू. दिस इज सेकेंड वे. थर्ड वे, दे ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू नो, they also want to know, and they are knocking doors here and there, and they don't know where to go, whom to trust, so they are asking you because you are so sincerely going different places. So they, what difference? Maybe they are seeing some difference in you, therefore they are asking, or they are asking because you go there and no difference has come. Ho sakta hai. I am putting all options in front of you. I am not here to judge or not, anything. I am putting you all options ki what must be going in people's mind. These are just few examples. There can be n number of things. We don't have to answer any damn question. Ha ha ha, woo karke nikal do.
They are judging you basically.
No, not again. You are saying you're fixed their behavior that it is judgment. No, it may be that they really want to seek, but they don't know where, so they ask her because they are close to her, so they ask her, what did you get from there? And when she's, if she says something, they take it with a pinch of salt. If she doesn't say something, she did not go there,
like,
but we don't answer everyone's question. If a person asks sincerely, then answer the question.
Swamiji, yesterday when I reached home, and my son-in-law asked me, what text you are doing there? Then I said, then he said, is it similar that when there's a conversation, he's reading those days, no? That conversation with Ramana Maharshi. So he was serious to ask what is in that container, what is it? So I just spoke about what we have heard here. So he was interested. So that's an inquiry. Because I know the aligned with that, but sometimes if somebody only for the sake of asking, and then they don't hear fully.
So you don't have to answer everything. मजाक मजाक में निकाल लो, चलो पकोड़े खाते हैं. और क्या? Best है. ज़्यादा seriously मत लो इन सबको. सब भूत हैं, imaginary. जिनको आपने अपना मान लिया है. कोई नहीं अपना. अपना सिर्फ एक है. कौन? शरीर नहीं, अपनी आत्मा. और वो अपनी भी नहीं बोल सकते क्योंकि वो हमेशा ही अपनी थी, हम ही हैं वो. बेवकूफ़ की तरह दूसरों के साथ लगे हुए हैं कि लोग ऐसे पूछते तो क्या करेंगे, पकौड़े खिलाओ जाओ उनका डर, उनको बोलो मैं टॉयलेट जाके आती हूँ. तो जब तक वापस आओगे वो क्वेश्चन ही भूल गए होंगे.
एक और बेवकूफ सा क्वेश्चन मन में आ रहा है कि सिर्फ ह्यूमन बीइंग्स का ही होता है कि ये जो सारी सृष्टि भगवान की बनी हुई है, इसमें भी ये
सोचने का
सोचने
the ability
की
to think is only with human being ना. बाकी सब तो instinctive है. They just react to the situations that life puts them in. Plant भी ऐसी करता है, पानी नहीं मिला तो सूख जाएगा, रोएगा थोड़ी ना. आप देख सकते हो उसका रोना, अगर आपके पास आँख है तो देख सकते हो आप. अगर आंख नहीं है, जो इनके पास कुत्ते बिल्ली हैं उनको देखो, वो तो उनके अंदर एकदम, ये देखो अभी ये गुस्से में है, देखो ये अभी चिड़ी हुई है, अभी ये देखो नाराज़ होके बैठा हुआ है. वो कुत्ते में भी देखते हैं, उनको अपने रिश्तेदारों में वो भाव नहीं दिखते, कुत्ते में दिखते हैं. तो इतना तादाद में हो गया है. इधर सर्विस सर्विस सब फेंक दो बाहर, सब बाहर. Understand the context in which here you are on self-enquiry. where is your duty and where is your service which you were so committedly doing in the dream? When you woke up, what happened to all that? Zero. See the addiction. इसके लिए convincing चाहिए. अपने आप को ही आप convince कर सकते हो, कोई और नहीं कर सकता. You have to convince yourself that I want to wake up from this waking dream. This is the topic that is going on. And the only way to wake up from this waking dream is become introverted towards the I, the conscious self, which is unattached, which is independent, which is all-knowing, which is ever in bliss, as bliss. Nothing is lacking in it. It wants nothing. It is short of nothing because it is complete. Purnamada Purnamidam. That I am, and here I am, I want to serve the world. Here I am giving a lecture. If I have a urge to give a lecture, it is a problem. If it is happening, it's okay. Something has to happen. In the world, something will happen. The phenomena is going on. Let it go on. You unclutch from the phenomena. You be the sakshi. That is what is told here. The quest taught by the master implies turning away from the world, because the mind has to be turned inwards towards the self. And this exercise I gave yesterday, eyes, looking at eyes. Similarly, this I, who is continuously defining itself by interacting with something or the other, this I must seek itself. Just like this physical eye tried to seek itself, see itself, everything vanished. Similarly, when this eye seeks itself, every thought in the mind will dissolve. That is the introvertedness. That is the turning around of the mind. He dwells within, but this has been said for the fully ripe aspirant who is not attached to the world. So, for whom is this exercise of coming back to the self, making a U-turn? Who has, pehle bataya tha na, atyanta vairagya, intense dispassion, intense detachment. If you don't have it, don't try. Try, I'm not saying don't try, try. But it will only lead to more confusion. Then what you should do? Do some exercise by which the mind calms down. And then come to this point. Then come to this point. So here he says, for those who are not yet ripe for the quest, this inquiry is not useless, as will be seen presently. So those who are not having intense vairagya, abhi ma, bete, pati, parents, grandchildren, sab mein phase hue hain, unke liye kya hai? But they think we are, you know, following the path of knowledge. I am into self-inquiry. But vairagya to kya kehte hain? Itna sa bhi nahi hai. Haan, vairagya is dispassion. It's not even ek tinke bhar ka nahi hai. And you want to do self-inquiry.
Situation ko react na karna can lead you to vairagya?
Yes. Yes. सिचुएशन को रिएक्ट नहीं करना, ये पहला स्टेप है. मन से भी नहीं करना है, वाच से, जवान से भी नहीं करना है, और एक्शन से भी नहीं करना है. और किसी के जवान से, मन से, या विचार से, या एक्शन से हमें डिस्टर्ब नहीं होना है. तो वैराग्य हो गया. इसी को बोलते हैं यम अनियम. फिर जाके आसन लगता है या प्राणायाम शुरू होता है. पर ये लोग आजकल के सीधे प्राणायाम इसमें जंप कर देते हैं. पहले तो दो स्टेप, दे हैव नॉट डन द फर्स्ट टू स्टेप्स, स्टिल सो 110% इन्वॉल्व इन द वर्ल्ड एंड दे वांट टू डू प्राणायाम. इट कैन ओनली क्रिएट एन अनहेल्थी माइंड, बिकॉज व्हाट इट विल डू इज इट विल काम योर माइंड फॉर अ सर्टेन बिट, एंड द डीप इंप्रेशंस विच आर स्टिल लर्किंग इन योर सबकॉन्शियस, they will come and create a havoc afterwards. पागल बना देते हैं, ये सब कोई सोचता नहीं है, ये कोई सोचता नहीं।
तो
हाँ, मेरे को तो अभी तो कोई नहीं मिला जो ये सब अलग अलग वीडियोस देख के प्राणायाम कर रहे हैं एंड दे बिकम हेल्थी। शुरुआत में सब, इन द बिगनिंग एवरी वन बिकम्स हेल्थी, बट वेरी क्विकली डिटेरेशन बिगिन्स बिकॉज नो बडी इज डूइंग इट विद दी क्या कहते हैं, स्टेप बाय स्टेप नहीं, नो बडी इज कंप्लीटिंग द होल थिंग, इट्स अ फैशन फॉर देम, इट्स नॉट अ कमिटमेंट फॉर देम, इट्स अ फैशन फॉर देम। प्राणायाम करना है, किस लिए करना है? प्राणायाम इज नॉट डन फॉर हीलिंग द बॉडी, योगा इज नॉट डन फॉर हीलिंग द बॉडी, दैट इज अ साइड इफेक्ट, बट दैट कैनॉट बी द मेन पर्पज। एंड वेन यू मेक दैट एज अ मेन पर्पज एंड डू इट, इट हैज टू गो द रॉन्ग वे आफ्टर सम टाइम। Quieten the mind.
Yep.
Yoga is to quieten the body. Pranayama is to quieten the mind. Pratyahara is a state where the mind, quietened mind, of its own accord, is not ready to go out of the senses, even if the world is presenting itself. Most beautiful things are there, but the mind is not ready to go out. It's hanging. Doesn't know where to go, what to do next. Not interested, but doesn't know where to go next, because it wants to think.
No interest, no aversion, but.
But it's in a standstill. It doesn't know what to do. Then comes dharana, dhyan, samadhi. So that quietened mind now is put into this introvert. Bola na ki turn it inwards. So you turn it inwards, because an agitated mind, a thinking mind, very difficult to turn inwards. A quietened mind available, no disturbances, no distractions, easy, there's no fighting there.
Okay. Unless one goes through this ashtanga, the eight steps, yama, niyama, pranayama, asana, all those things, if we don't follow, if we take somewhere in between, it is not going to be fruitful.
So therefore nobody should think that I'm an intellectual, that I only pursue self-inquiry, and look at their life, a big mess. Result of self-inquiry must be a calm, serene disposition, a joyful disposition. But they are imposing their will on the world. Param tu vairagya bale nahi na. जगत स्वतः सत्यमिति प्रतीत्या न साधनेन्तर्मुखतां भजन्ते तर्मुखतां भजन्ते तेषामपेक्षो हि विचार एषः। बट दोज हु हैव नॉट द नीडेड स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ नॉन अटैचमेंट, दिस इज common man, who are want to, in Marathi they say kalte pan valat nahi, in Hindi they say we know what to do but it's not happening. Hindi kya, English hum jante hain sab kuch par badlav nahi ho raha yaar. If I ask a question, cut cut cut, answers come, but phir, why it is not taking place? This is the reason. Because you are pursuing something, you want to eat the eighth chapati and be full. You haven't eaten the first chapati. You can be full only after you eat 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Eighth will fill you. Because eighth is making your tummy full, you want to eat the eighth one and feel full. It is not going to. So you want to do the inquiry and realize. But have you done the... have you eaten the previous chapatis, which was, as she said, don't disturb the world, don't get disturbed by the world. Like we were talking, then second step is, don't become a problem to yourself by your own thinking. then comes slowly, slowly, automatically the next step comes. First thing is you have to move around in this world like a zombie. Zombie, bhoot ki tarah. पता ही नहीं बाबा दोनों को दुनिया को बेवकूफ बना कहाँ से है हैं क्या खाएगा हैं
खा जा रहा है
कहाँ हैं मम्मी को क्या हो गया कुछ नहीं हाँ but those who have not the needed strength to of non-attachment जिनके पास वैराग्य नहीं है believing as they do that the world is real in its own right cannot turn the mind inwards for the quiet and for the quest of peace and tranquility. Very difficult. So for them this inquiry is surely needful. What is the inquiry now? The ephemeralism of the world, that the waking dream and deep sleep are unreal. This inquiry is required. For a person who's got vairagya, he doesn't need that inquiry. But those who are attached to the world, those who are attached to their sleep, those who are attached to everything, for them, the inquiry into the world, they don't even know majority that their world is waking, dream and deep sleep put together is their one experience of the world. They only think that waking is the world. For them, this inquiry is beneficial. Pehle aaya tha na ki, what is the need of inquiry then, if self is all that there is? But how many people know the self? So one who has vairagya doesn't need this inquiry. But those who are not having the vairagya, dispassion or detachment, for them this inquiry can be beneficial. एते विचारेण गुरुक्तरीत्या ते विचारेण गुरुक्तवीत्या जगन्न सत्यं स्वत इत्यवेत्य सत्यं स्वत इत्यवेत्य तथैव बुद्ध्याप्यनुसंदधाना बुद्ध्याप्यनुसंदधाना अंतर्मुखत्वं शनकैर्भजेयुः Kair bhajeyuhu. These, by making the inquiry on the lines indicated by the master, would become convinced that the world is not real in its own right, and then by reflecting on this truth will become able by degrees to turn their minds inwards. By degrees. You want to sit in samadhi straight away? Without having practiced, not getting disturbed by the world, not having practiced a disciplined life, not having practiced to sit in one place for even 5 minutes, 5 minutes, chalta rahega. Where? Not having practiced pranayama, little bit of hunger. Even in satsang, they want a tea, cup of tea and a glass of water and everything. You can't sit for 1 hour, 1.5 hour without water. Oh, I need to hydrate. Body identification. Simple. You have to let go of everything, including that cup of tea. Bhut ban ke baitho. Bhut samajhte ho?
Statue
is unmoving. So you have to be so focused that you are not even aware that the body is sitting there and watching. Because you are so engrossed in the self about which the teacher is talking. Not teacher self, yourself. Is type ka disposition. And it has happened here in this class. Yesterday, almost 2 hours the class went, we didn't even realize. See? So there, yesterday, the body was not like a statue, but the one within was so engrossed that if body is moving or not moving, it was not even registering it. Isn't it? That again and again bring yourself to that point of absorption, to that point of, that is only possible with focus. And for focus to come about, you must have no distraction. No distraction. So inquiry is necessary. How pursuing this world is taking us the wrong way. Then I should not work. Let it happen. Let it happen. Thus by making the inquiry on the lines indicated by the master, would become convinced that the world is not real in its own right. So once a new data is given to you, see, when you were a bachelor, it was a different rules we used to live. Once you got married, different rules, set of rules you have to follow. New data. Then the children came, again new data. From one job, you are with a certain data, you are functioning there. Suddenly you have to reorient yourself in a new workplace, isn't it? New data. Exactly the same way. If you want to go the spiritual way, then new data is required. And that new data states that this world is unreal. Now, instead of saying scriptures are wrong, teachers are wrong, masters are wrong, what is unwanted things they are saying, that this world is unreal. Is this unreal? See, this is so solid. Is it unreal? So instead of, but you don't do that. You, when you go to a new job, you mold into that environment because you want to survive there. That feeling of survival, that I want to be immortal, and that is only that it has not caught you yet. That I want to be ever free, it hasn't caught you yet. Because if it has caught you, then that is possible only when I'm established in the pristine self. And to be established in the pristine self, I need to re-evaluate the status of this world. Re-evaluate the waking dream and deep sleep. What is the re-evaluation? In one line, they are changing, therefore they are unreal. They are not worthy of my attention. Then what is worthy of my attention? That which can give me unbroken freedom. And that is the pure self. Then pursue that. But we are not. This will become able by degrees to turn their minds inwards. This knowledge is therefore not a mere luxury or speculative philosophy, but is of practical value as shown here. The necessity of guidance by a master in making this inquest on the world is next segment. So how to do the inquiry into the world, that is the next topic. So till now, what was being told? The importance of self-realization. What is the disposition of a man of realization? How does he look? What does he see from that pedestal of self-realization? What are your natural... it was also shown that nothing can come between the self and self-realization. There is no place for anything, not even for scriptures. Now, slowly, slowly, like every scripture, first the highest is presented, and then slowly, for less prepared student, then less prepared student, then the stupid fellow.
How to achieve now? It will come.
What is the ultimate? What is the disposition? How does a man of wisdom live there or be there? And some examples were taken. It was also told that no doctrines, dogmas, are required when it comes to the self. So don't get caught up in. Into logic, don't get caught up into religion, don't get caught up, because it's taking you away from everything.
Yeah.
Only when you get away from everything, you will be able to realize yourself. And this happens at sleep also. So then for who is the inquiry? A person who has got vairagya doesn't need an inquiry because he's already ready to be on fire. But the one who is still, remember what the mind, we told, the ಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತಮನ ವಿಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತಮನ ಮೂಢಮನ ಮೂಢಮನ ಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತಮನ ವಿಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತಮನ ಏಕಾಗ್ರಮನ ನಿರುದ್ಧಮನ. ಸೊ ಮೂಢಮನ ಡಲ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ನೆವರ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ನೋ ದ ಟ್ರೂತ್, ಫರ್ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್, ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್. ಯು ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಲೀಪ್, ಲೇಜಿ, ಡೋಲ್, ನೋ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇನಿಂಗ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್. ಮೂಢಮನ. ದೆನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತಮನ, ಎಜಿಟೇಟೆಡ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ರೆಸ್ಟ್ಲೆಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಡಸಂಟ್ ನೋ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಇವನ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನೆಸೆಸರಿಲಿ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್. ದೆನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್, ವಿಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತ ಮನ. ಸೊ ಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತ ಮನ ಇಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ಮೂಢಮನ. ಯಾ, ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಇನ್ ವಿಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತ ಮನ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಜಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ಲೆಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೆಜಾರಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್. ದೇ ನೋ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್. ದೀಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ದ ನಿರುದ್ಧ ಮನ, ನೋ ಮೈಂಡ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ನೋ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಬಟ್ ನೋ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಂಡ್ಯೂಸಿವ್ ಟು ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್? ಏಕಾಗ್ರ ಮನ. ಏಕಾಗ್ರ ಮನ ಇಸ್ ಫೋಕಸ್ಡ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, calm mind, content mind, single pointed mind. They are all synonyms. They are not separate. Single pointed, achha, I have to make my mind like this. No, but single pointed mind is also expanded mind. Expanded mind is also content mind. Content mind is also pure mind, nirmala. So don't only take one idea and get fixated. No, you have to think in its vastness, that all this is equal to single pointedness, or everything else plus single pointedness is equal to contentment. See, so this knowledge is therefore not, okay, the necessity for guidance by the master in making this inquest on the world is next explained. So education, inquiry, studies, whatever other people say, we also put it on YouTube. Everyone nowadays has become fashion, YouTube. Why? They want to do more with less. Why? Because we want to help. But if you take it with a pinch of salt, satsang must be with a living teacher. Satsang should not be with a video. Satsang should not be with a audio. Just like yoga should not be done by watching a video, pranayam should not be done by watching a video. You must sit with a real master teacher, and not one who has done 3-4 months of courses and then is teaching. It should be done when you be ready, you prepare yourself. Teacher will appear. You don't have to go and search for him or her. Life will be present. If that is your requirement, it will present. If it is not your requirement, it will shift your mind to something else, which is, so you have transcended it. See? So prepare. But our interest is, no, I want to know. I want a teacher. I want a guru. I want this. I want that. Yesterday I met someone, that fellow. He says, I have finished Bhagavad Gita, I have finished Upanishads, I have finished Brahma Sutra, I have finished this. I said, yaar, and he's saying it so passionately, I didn't want to break his train of thought. I said, I'm so glad that I met you and everything. But, and sometimes out of excitement it can come. But if it comes next time, then I'll have to tell him, because he's going the wrong way. He says, I'm taking classes. I said, you finished Bhagavad Gita, then how can you take classes? And I left it at that. Ya lokikenanubhavena charcha
swabuddhi shaktyapi vrithaiva sa syat.
Swabuddhi shaktyapi
वसा स्यात् बुद्धम् बुद्धं श्रयित्वैव गुरुं तु कुर्यात् तद्दृष्टरीत्यैव जगद्विचारं रीत्यैव जगद्विचारं एन इन्क्वायरी कंडक्टेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वर्ल्डली एक्सपीरियंसेस अलोन बाय रिलाइंग ऑन वन्स ओन अनएडेड इंटेलिजेंस इज वेन बिकॉज independent, oh, I want to study Bhagavad Gita, therefore I am studying Sanskrit. Many students coming to me who want to study Bhagavad Gita or some scriptures and they want to do it. No, I don't want to learn from anyone else. I want to study myself. And many of the people, they study Sanskrit and they want to know the what Bhagavad Gita is telling them, telling, they want to interpret it with their limited knowledge of Sanskrit. What they are going to come, what conclusion will they come to? Less than limited. It will be confusing.
What is suit to them?
Because if they have not purified themselves, whatever their convictions are, with those convictions they will try to, because that is their personality, that is their swabhav, with that swabhav, they are trying to interpret the verses of the Bhagavad Gita. So what verses are telling and what he is telling is totally different. Example, those who believe in duality, they take the Bhagavad Gita and they propound duality. Those who practice Ramanujacharya Pantha, they practice specific non-duality. They look at the same Bhagavad Gita and they give interpretation of Bhagavad Gita in that language. Then you get gyanis or tarka, logicians. They look at the same Bhagavad Gita, they bring out the logic out of the with every verse. Then you have Paramahamsa Yogananda. He looks at the same Gita and every verse he says this is pranayama and apan and kumbhak and he brings that out of that. You take a tantra fellow, he takes the same Bhagavad Gita and he brings that out. So which one is correct? It will all depend upon, are you qualified? So you get ready and a teacher will come. And don't get attached to the teacher or the book or the Bhagavad Gita. Then what? Get attached to the self. And never study it yourself, because it's very difficult. As I told yesterday, when I went, he said, come with an empty mind, study for 2 years, go with an empty mind. It's easy to program an empty mind, but a full mind, first the teacher has to work hard to empty it and then fill it up with the right stuff, isn't it? So if you have this arrogance that the whole all imposter swamis are roaming around and impost half-cooked yogis are there and I don't want to learn from anyone, I can find it within myself to do it, then prepare. It is possible, no doubt. But then live a life of dispassion, live a life of self-contemplation, and in that process, automatically Gita will come, other scriptures will come and you will understand it. Many masters have done it also. Because Guru is not a person, Guru is the principle, it is present everywhere.
So when they study any verse, they practice without going further.
There is no practice, Amma. Verse must reveal itself. Revelation only happens when mind is calm.
Contemplate on the verses.
Not contemplate also. Empty the mind. You are taking the verse and saying, how can I apply it in the world? That is practice for you. We are saying, empty the world out of your mind and then come in front of the verse and the verse will pop the meaning into your mind. It's a different approach altogether. And therefore, when you go to a master to listen, you feel, yeah, that's exactly how it affects you. because this is how he has studied, this is how he's speaking, he's coming from that space. Otherwise, just because someone has got a PhD or someone has written 10 books or someone has a big ashram is not equal to authority. Authority is only one, he who is established in the self. And how do you know he is established? Intense vairagya. Yet, moving through life with happiness. For them, this inquiry is surely needful. Ete vicharen, we did this, isn't it?
Yeah.
Thus, by making the inquiry on the lines indicated by the master, would become convinced that the world is not real in its own right, and then by reflecting on this truth, will become able by degrees to turn their minds inwards. And why it is told degrees? Because it will take some time for the dirt in the mind, unwanted thoughts in the mind, to slowly, slowly, as you remain focused, as you remain committed to the new conviction, the new data that has come into your mind. What is that? That the waking dream and deep sleep, for example, waking dream and deep sleep are ephemeral. They are unreal. Why? They are changing. Now this data is there. Now what do you do with it? After that, acha, waking dream and deep sleep. Acha, you know, tomorrow I have to go to work. What is there for breakfast tomorrow? I should prepare it tonight. You just now heard and now straight away you are into that. So what impact did it make on you?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Same.
Correct. And yet it has to be done, no? So are you with it? Are you with it? See, we live propelled by some expectation, propelled by guilt, propelled by desires. That is what initiates our actions. Something from within initiates, pushes us to act, like hunger comes from within and pushes us to act, or something outside grabs our imagination and we run towards it. Two ways. Can you sit still in spite of these two happening? Because neither you are the desire which is erupting. It is erupting in the mind. Let it erupt. You stand apart. And can you stand still even if something very attractive is there in front of you? Only that way. Only that way. For that you have to give zero value to the world. And slowly, slowly. So you understand, you have the answer, yet it has not gelled. Because dispassion is not there. For dispassion, the inquiry is there. So inquiry means, as Shankaracharya says, vivek vairagya. Inquiry into real and unreal generates more dispassion. More the dispassion, the deeper is the inquiry into the real and the unreal. So here he says, this knowledge is therefore not... we did this.
Yes, 76 here.
This also we did. An inquiry conducted on the basis of worldly experience alone by relying on one's own unaided intelligence is vain. One should resort to a guru who is a sage and make this inquest on the world only as guided by him. See, it is not told that go to anyone. It is not told, go to any Tom, Dick and Harry, only to a sage. And how will a sage come to you? Maybe you don't know who is the sage. Because how will you realize he is a sage? Isn't it? Then what can you do in the meantime? Start wherever. Don't get caught up in anyone or anything, your attention should be on subsiding your mind, purifying your mind. Take guidance from wherever it is available. Inquiry you commit under the guidance of a sage. Inquiry must be done with his words, by his guidance. One person I met, he had a job. Yesterday you met him. Passed out from IIT, working in Delhi. One day he came back to his house. He had got the salary the day before. Everything lost. The thieves came. Pura ghar tehas nehas kar diya. Everything outside the cupboards. Money gone, laptop gone. They left only one underwear for him. Even the clothes they took away. He immediately paid the rent, whatever kahin se leke, something like that he said. And then he went to Haridwar. Ekdam dispassion aa gaya. Took leave for 3 months, went away. Went there and at one shop he says, I want this color cloth. The shopkeeper gave it to him. Someone else gave him a kamandalu. And he started walking. Kept walking. Reached Rudraprayag. There he was sitting, what to do, kahan khana khaye. Didn't know, no money in the pocket also. So that Kali Kamli wala, he gave him a room and he gave him some food also. They don't give more than 3 days. So he stayed 2 days, continued walking. Walked somewhere, automatically, and he was practicing from before. He didn't want to get married or anything, and he kept walking. Where he's going, he also doesn't know. He was walking on the main road where the buses are not going. Suddenly there was a pathway, he turned, he went. After about 4-5 kilometers in a jungle, he saw one kutia. And when he reached there, the Mahatma inside said, come, you have come to the right place. He doesn't know him. Till today he doesn't know his name. Yeah, you come to the right place. You sleep in that corner. And every year, 3 months, he will go and spend with him. And one day, while he was there, or when he was in Delhi, the letter came. He came back from one of the trip, and he had his manager, he had a letter from his father. We have selected the girl. Next week is your marriage. Again went back. Kya karun? I want to go in this path. Now father is saying, do this, what do I do? He says, go. You will have to go. But then I want to follow this path, and I want to be, I don't want to get caught up. He says, no, you will not get caught up. Grace is there. She will leave you. He is saying to him, she will leave you. After 4-5 years, she went away with both the sons.
Can't they walk on the same path?
She didn't want to. The reason she left was, I don't want my children to become sannyasis.
Okay.
Think. Mm-hmm. And the rule was, 1 week with them, 1 week with him, 1 week with them. He says, I taught my children more than I know. So they are good at all chanting, they are good at pujas. So now she must be wondering, why did I go separate? He has taught them anyway everything. This is what I was afraid of. But anyway, Swamiji, I had 15 years of freedom, and I did my tapasya in those 15 years. And that guru, he doesn't know who is he. He went back, he couldn't find him there. And he says, everything that he has said is happening. He said, things will come, jobs will come, money will come, whatever is required. Satsang will happen, your contemplation will go on. You don't have to worry. Everything will start happening. Don't fight with anything. This is called?
Vairagya.
This is called trust.
Trust.
This is called faith in the higher. So his faith was in the Guru. That Guru told him, and his bindas. Have we found one altar where we are bindas like that? See? Everything we take with a pinch of salt. We put our intellect inside it. No, but this way or that way, I know better. I have seen the world more than you. You have seen waking. We have seen the three. You have only seen one. See? And he says, but I want to come back. He says, when the time is right, towards the end, last few years, you will again come back here and you will merge. It's a story. It's a story. That's what he's telling me. Why should I not? Okay, that is how it is. But this is these things happen today also. But for that, you have to be ready. You have to be ready for the higher to express. No inquiry can be made in a vacuum. But vacuum means you cannot make inquiry with an empty mind. For inquiry, thoughts are required. So then why did we empty our thoughts from the mind? So that the right thoughts can be introduced. So why did we empty the hard disk? So that new data can be filled into it, new program can be filled into it. So when the thing is full and you are putting new programs or apps, what is going to happen? Crash, crash, crash. Short ho jayega, crash ho jayega, it will not function properly. That is what our state is. Now understand this. Then how will it function better? When we reset the app, the laptop. Resetting means, pehle reset kiya, still it is not working. Empty everything, delete everything. Now 250 GB is available. All the old apps which could be corrupted, which could be having virus, all of them are removed out of the system. Now you can reprogram it. So same way, our goal of life for those who don't have vairagya should be to cultivate a zero mind. Reduce the number of thoughts. And with that, so when we say Samit Pani Shrotriya Brahmanishtam, so who is this fellow with the dry twigs? It means that person who has got no interest in the world anymore. Complete vairagya. But he doesn't know which way to go now. My question was also the same. I don't want to get caught up in devotion. I don't want to get caught up in knowledge. I don't want to get caught up in making ashrams. I don't want to caught up in cults. But I want to. No. Then but whom do I go to? Whom do I go to? I don't know who are the masters. One or two I went. They were very quickly, they wanted to take me. I took it. Phas gaya to. I don't want to get caught up. I was alert. But I kept remembering the Lord. Being available. And eventually, the teacher comes. No inquiry can be made in a vacuum, but only on the basis of reliable evidence. Speculative philosophers, as in the West, proceed on the false assumption that the worldly experience, the offspring of the primary ignorance, is good enough to be used as evidence for coming to a conclusion on a truth that transcends the world. No evidence in the three worlds, waking, dream and deep sleep. No evidence from these three can ever give you conclusion about the transcendental state. No, because that itself is a product of ignorance. Any evidence from there, any idea from there, itself is a product of ignorance. Waking, dream and deep sleep began, that world appeared only because you forgot yourself. Also, they believe that their intelligence is equal to the task of making a dispassionate inquiry. The knowledge derived from worldly experience is ignorance. The knowledge derived from worldly experience is ignorance. But what do we say? I have seen, I have not lost my hair just like that.
Experience.
So much experience has gone through. I'm 60 years old, I'm 70 years old. I've seen the world change in front of me. So is that the wisdom? Wisdom doesn't come from the world. Wisdom comes from the self, from the divine. The knowledge derived from the worldly experience is ignorance. Hence, there is no evidence, if relied upon, it will lead to wrong conclusions. And this is where many of the seekers get caught up. They get an experience of Kundalini and they get caught up. Oh, I think something is happening. But itself, it's an imagination of your mind. They see stars. These things happen. They see stars, they hear Om, they hear this, they hear that. They see, they have fantastic visions. For them, Bhagwan also comes and gives them darshan, they think I am realized. And these things do happen. But where are they happening? In the mind. If there is a name and there is a form, it is in mind alone. If, as fantastic as it may be, but it is in the mind. It's a figment of imagination, projected out of a quietened mind. And therefore a guru is required, that you don't get caught up and get sidetracked by this. See, Ramakrishna Paramahansa was so focused on Kali Ma, but he focused. He didn't know where to, what to do. He says, I want to experience Advaitic Samadhi. I want to go beyond form. Right now my mind can't imagine. Yesterday I gave you the story of Namdev Maharaj. Same thing. And then Totapuri Maharaj came from Puri, and for 3 days Ramakrishna Paramahansa was in Samadhi. And that same Ramakrishna Paramahansa then became the guru for Totapuri Maharaj. Because that fellow was only in Advait, he wanted, he told him that this world is also real, not the way of name and form, but it is also the expression of that one reality alone. But that you cannot come to that conclusion by where you are, you and me are. We have to be in the self. You have to have that experience what Ramakrishna Paramahansa had. Because other than reality, nothing exists. So how can world have a separate existence? Something to ponder upon. So here, and so that was possible. Why? He did not go to Puri to call Totapuri Maharaj. Totapuri Maharaj did not know that there is someone called Ramakrishna Paramahansa there. Yesterday's man did not know that there is a teacher waiting for him. See, when you click into the divinity, the creation, which is not other than, in essence, it is not other than deity, it starts helping you to progress very exponentially. It will bring the right person. Parshuramji went to Matangamuni. After he had to give his bow to Ramchandraji, Ramji sent him to Mahendra Parvat. He went to Matangamuni. He says, what is, Where is Brahman? Who is Brahman? What is Brahman? He said, you are Brahman. I am Brahman, Parshuramji, because he was so rajasic. He was a Brahmin but rajasic. I am Brahman. Just like that you told me I am Brahman. I didn't do anything. I killed so many people. 21 times I have rid the earth of all Kshatriyas. And you say, I am Brahman. He says, I cannot tell you any other way. You asked me a question, I gave you an answer. He says, but I did not do anything. I did not do any sadhana. I did not do any puja. I did not do any tapasya. I did not do any austerities. And I am Brahman. Yes, you are Brahman. In his mind, he is saying, I think he's gone cuckoo. And Matangamuni understood. He says, yes, you are right. Because after 2-3 times, every teacher will say, yes, you are right. No, not cuckoo. That you are right. Yeah, you have to do some sadhana. I'm sorry, but I'm not your teacher. Your teacher is Dattatreya Maharaj. You go to Mahendra Parvat, he's there. And he went. Oh, that Matangamuni told me, I'm Brahman. How can I be Brahman without doing anything? Addiction to doing. He says, yeah, you are right. He understood this needs a different treatment. He needs a different treatment. So what do I need to do? You climb the mountain, you dig the mud, you make the Devi, Tripura Devi, and then you eat on the floor, or sleep on the floor, take 3 baths every day, make nice food as prasad for her, and after offering the prasad, you eat only little bit, rest you give it to the birds and animals. And you do 108 parikrama of the Devi every day, morning, afternoon, evening. He did this for 12 years. After 12 years, one day, he lost it. Who, Parshuram? He said, bloody hell, I made the statue. Who is important? The maker or the statue? I give her everything. I wake her up, I make her food, I give her, put her to sleep. And I give her nice food, I eat fruits. I give her nice bed to sleep, I sleep on bare floor, bare ground. I give her, I put an umbrella on top of that, I sleep in the open sun. Who is more important? That is jada, that is inert, that statue. And I am living. So who is more important? I am. With this doubt he went to Dattatreya Maharaj. He says, this is my dilemma that I have come to. He says, who is important? He says, you are. Then, but I came, want to experience Brahman. Yeah, you are Brahman.
Again, back to normal.
But now he was prepared. Now he was prepared.
He can grasp that.
After 12 years of sadhana, he was prepared. Because if he was not prepared, another 12 years he has to go. So it takes time. It is, for very rare souls, it clicks at a young age or somewhere. But majority of us, it takes time. You need sadhana. A continuous application, alert application on yourself. Even right now, when I'm speaking, you have to be alert at the back. When you're listening, you have to be alert. When you are playing with your grandkids, you have to be alert. When you are talking to your kids or your partners, you have to be alert. What is coming out? Am I falling into attachment? Am I talking from that stillness? Is the speech coming or am I speaking? Majority of the time we are speaking. We are not aware that it is happening because of our identification. And it takes that much time, like Parshuram.
And for the need, if it comes, when speech comes, it is just coming, then we can see. But when we are making an effort, just as speaking, then it's become my speech.
True. It becomes my speech.
Yes,
I said so.
Yeah.
You have to follow.
Mm-hmm.
But if it is coming, and you say, like, Parshuramji went, I am Brahman, but I have to do something. One or two times he said, Baba, why you want to elongate your journey? That must be the thought going on. You are Brahman. He is established in Brahman. He sees Brahman. He asked the question, he answered. But when someone is insisting, I didn't do anything. Acha bhai. You need a different guru. Someone needs a strict guru, someone needs an emotional guru, someone needs a taskmaster guru, someone needs a guru who swindles all the money from him. You need that type of gurus also. Because your arrogance about your own success and money, everything is there.
Possessions.
Then whatever is required by that person in order to grow will come into that person's life. But here we digressed a bit. Point is that we must go to a sage. And who is the sage? The one who is established in the self. Get guidance from such a person. And then there is no question. Like one person I met, he said, you know, Om Namah Shivaya. I am good, everything is going fine. So, whom do you belong to? I said, to myself. Haridwar. I belong to myself. No, which ashram you belong to?
Myself.
Where is your ashram? Here. In this body, here, right now. This is my ashram. He said, but this is Swamiji's ashram. I said, am I not staying here? So this is my ashram also. Then what will happen after 2 days? I said, ashram will change. Wherever I go, or better I said, wherever I go, there is my ashram. Oh, aise hota hai. Then he started, jab usko aise dekha, felt nice. Now, dukhda bahar nikla. You know, my guru is a realized one, you know. I said, very good. Oh, who is this? Acha, so. Then, no, but we have a problem. I said, guru is realized and you have a problem. See, this is how the conversation begins. This is ashram conversation. My guru is realized, but I have got a problem. What? That guru has project after project after project, and I want to sit silent. But he doesn't allow me to sit silent. On the other hand, Tapon Maharaj was silent. He suggested Chinmayananda not to go out. But he had a itch to serve the world. He went and served the world. In the end realized his guru told the correct thing. After so many years. Yes, he created an organization, he brought the knowledge to so many people. But which people? Who are a part of a dream?
Yes.
What service are you doing to this world? It must be done. I'm not saying it is wrong. So here the problem is, my guru is realized. He can never come to know that a guru is realized or not. It's only his belief, his faith. But I have a problem. Meaning, samarpan is not there. Acceptance is not there. He's not ready to be molded by the teacher. Then he wants his conclusions of life to be supported by the Guru Maharaj. This is what we majority of the places do. We are not ready to be molded. Molding means then there is no complaint whether that Guru Maharaj is caressing you or scolding you or hitting you or sending away from himself or calling you again or insulting you in front of people. No complaint. Why? He's doing all that to check how baked you are. That is his process. That is his process. And you will find this. Now that I've told you this happens, now you go around in ashram, you see, it will be, you will observe it everywhere. Conclude here. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Just sit quietly for a minute.